Hello, my name is Abe, and welcome back to Enter the Gungeon. More like Enter the Fungeon. On the last run, spoilers, I played robot, I played double challenge mode, and I won. I frickin' won. That's right. Although I did kinda cheat. Not really cheat, but I got a little bit of help, didn't I? Picked up a rainbow chest, black hole gun, singularity ring of triggers, patriot. It was a absolutely amazing run. I think I had like 22 HP on the lich fight. That's ridiculous. So I want to play it again. I want to see if I can not beat that run, but at the very least prove that I don't need a rainbow chest in order to achieve victory here. So we're gonna give it another shot. Now this is another day. I was thinking of maybe doing a practice run, just normal robot run, going up to, or going down, I guess, to the glitch fight. But I decided, you know what, let's just do a double challenge mode run. This will be my warm-up. The hardest run I could possibly do, minus being cursed, I suppose. But cursed is not always a detriment. Sometimes it does help. Getting a cursed boss, obviously that sucks, but it's not that big of a problem for the robot. Because the robot only takes one damage from any source, regardless of whether or not it's jammed. You know, the big problem with the jammed bosses on normal characters is that you get hit and you take one full heart of damage. That's not a problem for the robot. If you get hit, you get hit for 1 point of damage. So the curse doesn't really apply. What the curse does allow you to do is get more money, and more money means more keys, more items from shops, more effectively HP when you can pick up armor. There's no armor on this shop, unfortunately, but you get the idea. There is, however, a potion of lead skin on this shop. Potshot Gorgon, which I really want. A potion of lead skin would be awesome. Potion of lead skin basically means you can flawless the first bosses. So I would love to get enough money for that. It's only 35. Probably means that we won't be able to buy a key, which is very unfortunate, but I kind of think it's worth it, maybe. Like, if I can buy Potion of Lead Skin or a key and go down to the Oubliette, I don't know. I might pick the Potion of Lead Skin. As much as I like the Oubliette, but hopefully we'll just pick up one key on the ground and then we don't have to make that decision ourselves. Pot shots, last bullet standing, a little bit annoying. I'm basically just gonna run around, do my best to get out of the way of enemies, shoot pots and books occasionally. There's no Blobulon Rancher or unfriendly fire I have to worry about. We can kinda just do this. Alright, we can kill him now. Good. Long live the king, cursed ceramics. You are the king, buddy, over there.
Got hit by an R attack.
I didn't get hit by it, but I was going to. Great. Get out of the cursed pot, you son of a gun. The modifiers actually are not affecting me anymore because cursed ceramics, you know, pots, we can just shoot the pots. And long live the king. Well, the king died in the very first wave, didn't he? So I like Long Live the King when it's not a problem to kill the king. I hate it when it's a narrow hallway and you have to really work your way towards the king because it can just kill you pretty quickly. Oh, yeah, I took damage. I thought I could roll into the middle of the shockwave and be safe, but instead I just got hit by it like an idiot. I should not have taken damage there, but I did. I do not expect this run to be very good, considering the play that we've had in the first floor here. The first floor, as a robot, even on challenge mode, you really shouldn't be taking this much damage. If you're taking this much damage, you should not expect to succeed. We might have to get carried by a good item. Give me the Mega Hand, give me the Heroin, give me another Black Hole Gun or something at this point, because I think I'm playing absolutely like garbage. But we'll try. We'll give it a shot. I will not relent. I will not give up. Never give up. Never surrender. I don't know who said that, like Winston Churchill or something? Someone famous. I'm joking, by the way, I know who said that. It's Woody Allen, right? Well, the king, not a problem. Gorgon's gaze, not a problem when it's just three bulletkin. There's the key, so we can go down to the oubliette and buy Potion of Lead Skin. Almost have enough money to get them both, which would be wonderful. Potion of Lead Skin is worth getting rid of coolant. Let's keep using the coolant for the rest of this floor. As soon as we find the boss fight, then we'll go buy the Potion of Lead Skin. Because I don't want to use Potion of Lead Skin on a room. I would rather use the coolant. And the reason for that is very simple. I want to have Potion of Lead Skin available on the boss fight whenever I need it. You see, I like rooms like this where the king spawns right next to you because then you don't have to worry about finding him. You can just go hit him and kill him. Pushing the lead skin is a take. We have enough for the key. I'll just buy it right now so I don't forget about it. And we will fight the boss, whoever you are. Gull. Gull. Poison Pursuit plus... an additional Gull's Revenge, kind of annoying, but that's okay. Whenever we need to, we can pop the Potion of Lead Skin and be invincible to both the missiles and the poison, and his bullets. Might just do that right now. He's poisoned. I can walk him into this thing, drop it down on him. Potion of Lead Skin's going to run out. I do not like the position we've got ourselves in, but he's almost dead. He's dead. Okay, so we did flawless the first floor boss. We're gonna pick up one more armor at least. And we actually get the dueling laser, which is pretty decent. It allows you to occasionally have a single high-powered shot that can kill most enemies in one hit, and then it recharges as you deal damage, just like an item, but it's a gun instead. So you can't use this. Well, it's technically infinite, it has infinite ammo, but you basically use it, switch to another gun, kill some stuff, switch back to the dueling laser, fire it off. It's a really good weapon, I like it. Unfortunately, we don't have anything to use the ammo for, so I'm just going to leave it, shoot the rat a few times, and go open the rest of these chests, because I do need guns, better guns. I need a gun that can potentially allow me to find a secret room. Elder Blank. Oh, but the Elder Blank... Okay, question. Elder Blank or Potion of Lead Skin? Ideally both. This sucks. This sucks because it's so good. Okay, first of all, no secret room. We're just gonna use the Elder Blank because it's free. This shouldn't be raising our curse, by the way, whenever we drop it, but I wanna open the blue chest just in case it is a backpack, because having both Elder Blank plus Potion of Lead Skin would be absolutely amazing. So I am going to train this all the way to the blue chest. I can't teleport to it because the rat will steal it, but I want these both. Come on, give me a backpack. I never get the backpack. I assume that there can be a inventory increasing item from this. It doesn't need to be the backpack. It could be the yellow belt. I forget what it's called, but it basically does the same thing. More ammo, more item space. It's the Orgunny. Right, it's a gun. I'm an idiot. I'm an idiot. Of course it's a gun. Well... Potion of Lead Skin or the Blank? I think I like the potion better. Potion of Lead Skin basically makes you invincible to everything. The Elder Blank does increase your curse. It's a good item, but they're both good items. Wow, this sucks. I guess we just take the potion. I like the potion because it does allow you to rebound enemy bullets back, and it also, I think, gives you longer invincibility. You know, the blank, it blanks the screen. The potion of lead skin makes you invincible for about 10 seconds. That's more time than you get out of the blank, allowing you maybe to deal more damage. Okay. I don't know which one charges faster, but we'll keep the potion. This is like the best worst floor. We got hit a couple of times, we're down to 5 armor, and we have 2 good items that we can't take with us, or 1 good item that we can take and 1 good item that we have to leave behind. This is extremely unfortunate. I mean, it's good. I mean, having choice is good, but I would have definitely preferred better. Gun Q Gorgon's Gaze. Thank you. That gun. Tried to hit the ghost, but unfortunately the ghost disappeared before I could hit it. But that is Dueling Laser. It's really good. I do not like this. We're kind of stuck. Come on, kill him. It was, Thermal Clips and something else. I forget what the something else was. Dueling Laser almost charged. Pot Shots. Dueling Laser is charged. I'm gonna wait on it for when the mushrooms spawn, because mushrooms do spawn here. Gotta be careful about the trash bags as well. Just wanna take them out so that I don't accidentally take damage on them. Good, we did hit both of the mushrooms with the Dueling Laser, easily killing them both. Excellent. It's no longer charged right now, but that's okay. I don't think there's gonna be a secret room here, at least not right now. We'll just jump through. I'll find the secret room at the end of the floor. Don't blink zone control. I like don't blink zone control, especially on these guys, because they literally just don't move. I can just kind of keep them in my sights. I got you in my sights. Anything don't blink, I love. Even if it doesn't seem like I love it, I love it. Hey, we killed him. Might want to try like min-maxing this a little bit, trying to get a little bit of additional money out of it by shooting these guys when they are jammed. And then if I kill them, get some more money out of it. I don't think they heal when I don't think they heal whenever I move the light in and off of them. It used to be that they healed, but I think they changed that a long time ago in the supply drop update when they added this stuff. Yeah. Okay, so don't blink. I'm not gonna do don't blink Blobulon Rancher unless I have a good opportunity to do it. I kind of learned that lesson last time, but I should try to min-max a little bit if I can. We'll try to use a little bit of Origunny here, just in case we come across an ammo drop. Can't open the chest anyways. Okay, long live the king. So we gotta find the king. I don't think there's a reason to use the Dueling Laser right now. There's going to be the big bat that spawns, and I want to kill the bat with the Dueling Laser if I can, because he's gonna be super annoying. Where he spawned. There he is. So we kill the bat immediately. The big bat. Whoa, what is that? Is that a bouncing bullet from a long time ago? That was scary. There's the ammo drop that I had the Origunny for. So, might as well spend some time. I don't think this room can have a secret room. I don't remember there ever being one here, but we'll shoot some walls. We have the ammo drop. Yes, maybe we could use it to immediately recharge the Dueling Laser, but why? I think it's more worthwhile to spend the ammo with the Origunny. It's not going to be there. Could be here, maybe? Pretty much out of locations, so I'm just going to take the ammo and go. Origunny's not too bad, but definitely don't really want to use it if I have to. If I don't have to. I do have the dueling laser. I'm going to use it. Buy myself some time and space. This is a really annoying layout for zone control, because you actually do have to get into the zones. I should be shooting. I do have the potion of lead skin. I could use that whenever I want, but I think we can actually handle this. Use the dueling laser a little bit. Ah, here's where there's two boxes next to each other. That's really nice. Okay. It's also poison pursuit. Of course! Of course! I can see the poison. Kill what you can. There is a bat. Dueling laser is nowhere near charged up. Can we kill this guy? Okay. We're fine, we're fine, we're fine. I got worried there for a second. No reason. No reason to be worried. Kill the big bat. Big bat is dead. Little bats are dead. And the room is over. Okay. I was expecting there to be a third wave. I think normally there is a third wave on that room. Trap room. Hopefully we don't have to go that way. If we do, I might wait for the end of the floor, because then I could just use a blank at the end. Or I could use the potion of lead skin. I haven't used it yet outside of that one boss fight. There's almost no reason for that to be the case, that we should use it whenever we feel like we need to. Alright, dueling laser. High stress, don't blink. But there's only these three guys, right? Don't like this. I don't like this at all. Let's push that. Break all of these because I have PSD over pot shots. Okay, we killed one of them while he was jammed, so he dropped $5. We get a tiny, tiny bit of knockback from this, so we can keep this guy at bay. Additionally, that cube, since it has an animation time on his attack, we should be able to keep him permanently locked in. He looks like he also might be stuck on the barrel, so we're just gonna keep this up. I'm gonna try to do this more smartly than I have done in the past, that's for damn sure. You might say that this isn't smart at all, that I should just kill them and get on with it. That might be the case. Could light them on fire to help, but I kinda want to have better opportunity to kill them on my time. Now with only one of them, and I know what his attack is, and he can't hit me with it, just kinda do this, this, this. What I really want right now, I think, is something that can light enemies on fire. Because if I can light enemies on fire, if I get Blobulon Rancher, I might be able to cheese the game and get, like, infinite money out of the blobs. As is, this might take a while. There we go, we killed him. We got, like, 9 credits out of that one room. If we can do that on every room that has Don't Blink, we could get a lot of money. Gull's Revenge, Shockwave, you die. There comes the Shockwave. Gotta remember, I don't need to worry about the actual Shockwave bullets. They can't hurt me. The Shockwave laser can't hurt me as Robot, because we are immune. Crown of Guns. I don't think so. We should buy one key, because we're going to want a key. I wish there was armor on the shop. I will say that for damn certain. Explosive Pyre, Unfriendly Fire. This is one where I'm going to use Potion of Lead Skin basically immediately. This room sucks. It's Explosive Pyre, so it shouldn't be that bad, but this room can go to hell. Some of the challenge modifiers can make this not impossible, but pretty dang hard. And we'll get the Potion of Lead Skin back. Don't worry about it. Curse Ceramics, Thermal Clips. I think I'm just gonna do that. I didn't want the blue guy to come after me because he shoots three times, or not three times, twice, excuse me. Ghost is dead. Blobulon's turn. Good. And I didn't reload accidentally, even though I had thermal clips. Excellent. Much better play on this floor than the last floor, that's for damn certain. Okay, there's the armor shard, the armor piece, whatever you want to call it. Still no secret room. I have no idea where it is. And we actually do have to cross over the Pit of Gondor here. I don't know anything about Lord of the Rings. However, what I do know is that I will probably try to cheese this a little bit by teleporting away. Waiting a second, and then teleporting right back. Nah, we'll just do it like this. Okay, good. Good, good, good. Okay, and that should be the boss fight. It is. We do not have the Potion of Lead Skin. That's okay. We are going to use Dueling Pistol, Dueling Laser Robot's right hand. We got two blanks. Poison Pursuit, Adrenaline Rush. Adrenaline Rush sucks. Poison Pursuit sucks. Dueling Laser should help make this not so bad. I am gonna blank there. I think I'm running too much. I'm making a lot of poison on the ground, not giving myself a lot of space. He's splitting. Just gonna stay in the middle. Almost got hit by the poison, I think. Potion of Lead Skin is now charged. We should use it whenever we feel the need. Whenever we feel like we don't want to use a blank. Right now. I didn't like the position I was getting myself into. We can get close to him, do a lot of damage. Potion of Lead Skin is going to be reflecting bullets. He's also poisoned, thanks to Poison Pursuit. Dueling Laser finished the job. We picked up two armor. And the rad gun! Okay, this run has suddenly got serious and a lot cooler. So rad gun is a coolness upgrade, a cool stat upgrade. That is the first important thing to realize about the rad gun. Second important thing to realize about the rad gun is that it does a heck of a lot of damage. It is fantastic. Okay, so what the heck do we do right now? I'm just going to look for secret rooms. I've already shot these walls. Let's just do it again. Open one of the chests. We get a shot bow. Shot bow is not bad. Pretty decent knockback, I think. So now we just got to look for a secret room and then leave. I'm going to look in the exit room. I might blank in the shop. I don't really think the Origunny is that important for us. I think maybe the robot's right hand might just be better. So if I have to use it to look for a secret room, I will do so. We might not find a secret room, but just in case we do. Don't know how many shots it takes to find. I'm just gonna spam bullets, because again, this gun doesn't really mean all that much to me. Don't see any secret walls. We will move on. Let's go here to this room. Don't think it's going to be on the left wall because there's a garbage bag. I think it pretty much, secret rooms have to be on a wall, in an area on a wall where there's nothing. That seems to be the case most of the time anyways, so kind of focusing on that. It's not going to be there. I don't think it's going to be between the shop and the crest room. Could be straight down from here. Maybe, but I don't know. Could be. You know, I don't think it's going to be off of. Actually, it could be off of this room, right here. No, let's look up the top. No, it's not gonna be here, it's not gonna be there. I guess it could be in this room somewhere. I believe this was a don't blink room. Although I'm not seeing it. This is very unfortunate. That room, we did have a lot of origami ammo, so we did shoot a lot of the walls in there. I'm not really being very thorough, but again, I just want a simple, quick check to try to find it. I can't find it. So I'm not entirely sure what we do except blink in the shop, and then we leave, unfortunately. We're gonna be going down to the next floor with no keys, only 7 armor, which is not that much. It's not that much armor. Just checking. We will blow open the last chest. And, oh boy, half of a red heart. Lovely. We'll go down to the next floor. So, we're going to be relying, I think, on Radgun. This gun is amazing.
Nice.
You just got to reload it. About 4 times. And then when you reload it 4 times, you get the sweet, sweet suns with sunglasses. And those suns with sunglasses do a lot of damage. They one-shot most enemies. So, I mean, ideally we can just kill everything, can't we? Like, completely murder.
Cool.
We'll do one more reload just in case there was a passive reload. Changing floors. Gull's Revenge, Shockwave, Pot Shots. Pop, pop, pop. That's the power of Radgun. This is basically a mega hand or heroin that you can't really use effectively in the middle of combat. You kind of have to prepare it. You don't charge it, so it's got that going for it as a benefit, but you've got to do those 4 reloads before you actually walk into a room. And hey, wow, this was extremely quick getting to the Abbey elevator, so to speak. I might go to the Abbey, I might not. I did not go to the Abbey on the last run, and I think I was better for it. I guess there is 1 enemy left. I think it was unfriendly fire, so I just wanted to be a little bit careful. So that's whack. Just do that 4 times. We're ready to go. What I should do, also, is don't waste the 4 shots when you do the reloading. Just shoot them into a wall in case there is a secret room. I forgot to do that. I will do that next time. We do have the dueling laser. We don't really need to use the dueling laser, but we can. Like right now, because this is hammer time. Oh my god, what is happening? Holy crap. Hold on. I need to take a drink of water. What the hell was that? That ghost came out of nowhere. It was Ghost in the Shell, I think, and I forgot about it. Or didn't realize it. Or maybe it wasn't Ghost in the Shell. Yo, whatever that was, that sucked. Don't know why a bullet came at me at the very end, but that's okay.
Nice!
Let's keep moving on here. Dueling laser almost charged. Long live the King, Blob Gorgon. I wanted to fire that off because I knew it could kill a lot of those little guys, those little bats. We are not done. We've got a Mace Man, and it's Blobulon Rancher, so stop missing. I wanted to use the dueling laser because I didn't want to have to try to reload the rad gun in combat. I did waste a couple of shots with it, but it's gotta happen sometimes. There's a cell creep. We can sell maybe the origami to him. Or maybe something else if we get items that we don't want. This is a very simple room. Gorgon's Gaze, Dark, Don't Blink. Gorgon's Gaze, Dark, Don't Blink. Got an idea. Kill enemies when we can by not looking at them, get some additional money. The rad gun's really good for this sort of thing. There's two more enemies on scope. We can't move though. There's one. There's the other. Excellent. And we are gonna take radgun ammo. We might as well spam shots. It doesn't matter if they are properly reloaded. I'm just looking for secret rooms and stuff. All right, so this room has been cleared.
Cool.
Nice. Rad. All right, ready to go. I don't know if that's fully charged or not. I wish the UI for that was a little bit better. Nothing's gonna like come after me and hurt me, so I can spend a little bit of time kind of killing these guys at a range that is appropriate for my survival. And we'll switch to the pistol. I don't want to stay away from the rad gun for too long, because if you do stay away from the rad gun, it reloads on its own, and you lose half of your damage bonus or something like that. So I definitely want to stick with the rad gun for as long as possible. Rat cursed adrenaline. Easy. I am going to do a reload on the rad gun. Just wanted to kill some pots.
Nice.
You got it. Nice. Green chest. Gorgon's gaze, don't blink. Ghost in the shell. Look, oh, yeah. Oh, ghost in the shell. Ghost in the shell. Ghost in the shell. Fuck. Fuck. Just kill him. I think I looked right at it. Oh shit. Okay.
Whack.
I am just like freaking the fuck out right now. I think we're safe though for a minute. Oh my god. I should have just been firing like way faster. Rad. I'll wait. I will wait. His gun is moving. I will wait. I want to kill all these four Blobulons when they are jammed. Guess I got to do one more reload.
Cool.
Got it. Cool. There are reinforcement waves as well. It is Ghost in the Shell, but I don't think a ghost spawned there. I am just being very careful with checking. But I don't think a ghost spawned there. We can kill this ghost. Two shots. All right, we didn't take damage. It's probably more than I could have hoped for on that room. Oh my god, I played that so poorly. So poorly.
Nice.
I just got to thinking about the possible money that we could have made from that, and then I just kind of just lost focus. I should have just killed a few enemies, gotten a safe space, and then worried about farming money if I could. So that is definitely a my bad situation. We've got Dueling Laser ready to go, though. That's the boss fight. Honestly, I want to keep going. Keep exploring. Do we? Yeah. We don't have that good of equipment. Rad gun we can charge whenever we need to. You know what? This is a good opportunity, I think, for Potion of Lead Skin. Because there was a Deadeye, which I hate, and he was right next to us on the spawn, which I hate. And he was also Last Bullet Standing, which I hate. So I do not mind that at all.
Cool.
Rad.
Cool.
Okay, we got the cool. Zone Pot Shock. I really do not like this. I ran into a pot. I ran into a pot. Just straight up ran into a pot. Fuck, I hate pot shots. It is the worst. The actual, factual worst. Morgan's gaze, get out of here. Really, I'm just worried about a ghost spawning behind me here. We do have to reload. We got the reload, and we're cool. A little bit of damage is okay. You can take a little bit of damage and still be fine. We used a blank, we got a blank. I risked it. Ultimately, it was meaningless. The judge, it is okay. The other green chest, I'm gonna open because we have the keys available and green is a decent color. It's gonna be a passive or a active. Hopefully it's a passive or a backpack or something. Amulet. Amulets are nice. They kindle one ammo or one blank per floor. So I definitely do not mind that. Might sell the origami? It's not very good. Alright, we'll start with the rad gun. Dark hammer pot shots. Are you kidding me? Yeah. We'll switch to the dueling laser and then the judge. Okay, we got the invincibility. We're not gonna be able to kill the boss in one go here. One go of invincibility. I took damage at the very end. Fucking hammer time. It is the absolute worst. It is the absolute worst. I'm selling Helix Bullets immediately. I have fallen for the Helix Bullets trap way too often. I just want money at this point. God damn. Hammer time. Every time, it's hammer time. Ugh. Are we going down to the Abbey? No. We have no good boss killing guns. We do have Potion of Lead Skin, but by itself it's not good enough. We don't have, you know, any. Actually, we do have a cool upgrade, but as we've seen, it's not good enough. So we're just gonna go. We're just gonna go. We got a lot of money, nothing to spend it on, unfortunately. I could have bought ammo. Radgun ammo, though, goes a long way. It really does. We should not have any problems with ammo with this gun for quite a while. We should be able to do the entire floor, essentially, with just this gun. Ah, hammer time! So we've already gotten to the point where enemies don't die in one shot from Radgun, but they might now that I've done another reload. So four might not be enough to kill the blue guys, five might be. Ghost hammer time, thermal high stress. Are you kidding me? Yeah. So five reloads is enough to kill. Okay, I should have probably taken damage there. Five reloads is enough to kill blue shell guys.
Whack.
So one, cool. Two, cool. Three,
nice.
Four. I should be looking for secret rooms. I'm not. We have potion lead skin. Dark hammer and hammer! Go away, hammer. Starting to just get scared, basically. All right, hammer's gone. Get out of here. We didn't take damage. Didn't take damage. There's that. This should be a super easy room. Those guys die immediately.
Whack.
And then we whacked. I'm not gonna jump over there just to shoot the wall. Shoot him from here. Blob, thermal, pot, cursed ceramics. Oh, lovely. Blob, thermal, pot, cursed ceramics. Why did I blank? I should have potioned of lead skinned. Damn it, damn it, damn it, damn it. I should have potioned and I was an idiot and did not do that. So I kind of just wasted a little bit of ammo, unfortunately. Or not ammo, but blankage. Blankage is very important for the boss fight. We want to get that flawless so we can get more armor. I just panicked, hit the wrong key. It happens. Two keys plus armor. A door with a blank salesman. Chaos amulet is good. Table tech blanks. Now we're talking. Now we're talking. Being able to blank probably half of all rooms for free could be really damn good. Really damn good. I want dueling laser. I need to remember I've got this stupid dueling laser. Don't blink. Unfriendly fire, explosive pyre. So this should be pretty easy. This is just... killed him. It's explosive pyre, but I figured we were out of his range.
Whack.
I'm whacking here.
Cool.
Right. Unfriendly fire.
Nice. Nice.
Just want to kill him while he is... jammed. I don't know how much money we got out of that, but we got a little bit. Okay, we didn't have to blink. We didn't get hit. Let's keep moving on. Hammer, blob, final. Oh, God. How did I get through that without taking damage? Oh my god. Final unfriendly gull. You know what? Don't blink, Blobulon Rancher. Dark was the night. That was the other one. I was wondering why it didn't seem that bad. That bad. Let's wait for the bullets to pass, why not?
Noise!
Noise! You are annoying. He opened up. I'm just gonna shoot him. Okay. We almost have enough for table tech blink. I want it. I want it. Hammer. Hammer time! The laser hit me because I wasn't looking for it. The frickin' hammer times are getting ridiculous, game. Oh my god! Stupid. We have to open this. We have to open this. It's the Dragon Fire. It's okay. I was kind of expecting more out of such a quality chest, but that's okay. It should be a really good boss killer. And we don't really have any other boss killer, so you know what? I take it back. That's a good pickup for us right now. Should allow us to get a flawless here, even with Potion of Lead Skin. Even with? Even only with two blanks instead of three, because I wasted one earlier. So let's not be hasty. Let's get the potion charged. Let's get the dragon fire ready to go. Just checking. Rat, Gorgon, poison, explosive. Well, you first, you second. Luckily, those laser guys don't actually move. Don't want to explode on me. I actually got a chest out of it. How strange. Not a mimic. Winchester rifle is okay. And that's all I will say about that. All right, let's fight the boss right now. Should we? Let's keep going. I'm really into the idea of maybe getting another passive before we fight that boss. Zone final last. This is so bad. Yep, there goes some more armor. You know what? I should have bought the blank. I should have bought the blank before I came in here. Damn it. Because I could have easily blanked all these guys.
Whack.
I do not care about whack right now. Yeah, or Gunny's not very good. We did find a secret room. It did contain a key. Let's go buy Table Tech Blank, because we could have easily done that room with Table Tech Blank. That's so dumb. Well, we have the Potion of Lead Skin, we have Dragon Fire, plus Dueling Laser we can open with it. Pot Shots. I don't think there's any pots. Rat's Revenge, Dark Woods of the Night. You know what? Potion of Lead Skin these guys. Because this is a very annoying room. I can't see the mines around me! Reload. This gun does take a million years to reload, it seems like. I did blank, I didn't take damage. These fuckers again. I don't want to shoot them. I really don't want to shoot them. Got him. We got the right one. Oh, and it's explosive pyre. We don't have to worry about that. That's really good. All right, we have invincibility. Pop it immediately. We got to do faster damage here. All right, I think that was a flawless. That was very sketchy. I do not like how close that was, but we did get Unicorn Horn. Unicorn Horn is really good. I'll take Dragon Fire. I actually think that the gun did not perform quite up to my expectations, or maybe I didn't perform up to expectations, but the Unicorn Horn is quite good. Especially with Potion of Lead Skin, because with Potion of Lead Skin, you don't have to dodge.
Nice.
And if you don't have to dodge, you can just stand there, fire out the Unicorn Horn, do a lot of damage. Rat Thermal Gull. Did whack. So we're gonna pop this. Forget that we light on fire. Just use the Winchester. It's pretty good for situations like this. Yeah, there we go. I'm not gonna say easy. Alright, we got whack, so we're gonna have to reload again. There is the chest. We've already found the secret room. It's a mimic. I was waiting to see if it was a mimic, and it's a mimic. So what are we gonna do? We're gonna shoot it. We're gonna lure it into this room, and it can't get us from the other side of the gap. So I might as well just not waste ammo in the rad gun. There's no modifiers. just kind of stand here and shoot at it forever. And it should drop its item not in the pit. It's going to be a passive or active. It's going to be green level. I don't like that there's that table there, fortunately, but there's not much I can do about it right now, except keep shooting. I don't want the item to, like, bounce off of the table or something. Yo, these Rat's Revenge traps are freaking me out right now. I really don't want to walk over them, even though they can't activate. Alright, you know what? I missed with the dueling laser. I guess you won the duel chest. I'm focusing on dodging, not necessarily on aiming. That's why I'm not really hitting. But he did die. We got Gun Knight armor! Oh, yes! That's so good! That's actually really good. Gun Knight armor. I wish I could steal, because I would love to steal the Chaos Amulet. More amulets, more blanks. Let's move on. Alright, we've got some decent stuff going on here. We've got the Rad Gun. Gun Knight armor. Table Tech blanks plus poison blanks. Freezing blanks would be better, of course, but we don't have those.